Hello, I will show you how to use Babette by first comparing it to the graphical user interface tools it tries to be an alternative of. So I show you the graphical user interface workflow, and then I will show you how to do the same and more using Babette. So the normal workflow is like we want to run Beast 2, but for that we will need to create an input file. With Beauty we can do so. It's a very user-friendly program. We have to input a DNA alignment. I use a pipette FASTA file. I have to specify its nucleotides, and then I've loaded my alignment file. I can specify side model. I won't do that. I can specify a clock model, a tree prior. What I will change is the length of the MCMC chain. Otherwise this video would take too long, just waiting for the simulation to finish. So I'm going to save this. I call it demo, and demo is the name of the Beast 2 input file. Now it's time to run Beast 2 then. I'm going to use a seed of 1 on that input file. So I'm going to use a seed of 1 because I will show you that Babette will give exactly the same results as other tools do. So I'm going to run Beast 2 here, and you see it's already finished because it's a short run. It's too short to have a proper inference, but for the sake of this demo it's fine. Now there are some files created, and I'm going to use a tool called Tracer to check the log of the created posterior. So what Tracer shows me, it shows me the parameters that are estimated, like the posterior likelihood, prior tree likelihood, tree-eyed Yule model birth rate, the effective sample size, some summary statistics, and a trace of all these variables that have changed during the Beast 2 MCMC. So take a look at the birth rate, because I will reproduce this exactly same curve in Babette. Notice that this works great if you only have one input file, but imagine working on thousands of input files. You already had to, in Beauty, you had to already load 1,000 different of alignments by hand, and now you would have to analyze 1,000 traces by hand. Another tool that's commonly used together with Beast 2 is called DensiTree, and that will display all the trees in the posterior. Well, it's rather neat. It shows all the posterior trees on top of each other. You can have a consensus tree and so on. So that's cool. That's cool. Now we are going to do exactly the same in Babette, and I could prepare a script. So I can, and that's a feature of using Babette. You can just prepare the script already. So I'm going to run Babette, and with Babette I'm going to run Beast 2 on that same FASTA file, using a shorter MCMC chain length. Actually, create MCMC gives you all the options, like chain length or store every number of samples. You can put it in there, and I also specify this random number generator seed of 1. So I run Beast 2 here, so it creates the Beauty configuration file, and then runs Beast 2, and then converts all the output files to data that we can use in R. So if we just take a look at what is the output, it consists of a list of 3 items, one called Antus Aco Trees, which are the trees, Estimates, which contains the parameter estimates, and Operators, which contain the operator acceptances during the MCMC run. And of course you can just do out dollar estimates, for example, and now we see a data frame with all the parameter estimates. Well, let's plot those. So I'm going to use ggplot2 for that, and of those estimates I'm going to use as an x value the sample index, because that just increases every 1,000, and I'm going to plot it against the birth rate. Right, and if we now zoom in, this was exactly the same curve that was shown in Tracer. Of course, we can do much more, but I won't go into more details. Additionally, perhaps you want to see the posterior trees. Well, there's a function called plotDensityTree that in the back end uses Fangorn to do similar things as DensityTree does. So Fangorn has a lot of options. I'm just going to show you the default settings. I did make the lines a bit wider, so it would be a bit clearer if this video gets a bit compressed. But you can see it can display all those trees. And there are many, many options in Fangorn. So what's different is that I have actually access to the data now. So from my posterior trees, I can say, hey, I'm going to use Ape, and I'm going to plot the first one. Or I'm going to plot the second one. And you can do all nifty things on those trees. You still have access to that data. Or, for example, use the normalized linear through time plots package and plot the number of linear through time of your first or your second or whatever tree. So that's what Babette can do. It can give you a viable alternative to all those graphical user interface tools. It allows you to write R scripts, prepare R scripts, loop over site models, clock models, tree priors, thousands of alignments, that's all fine. And then it gives you data that you can easily use within all the other packages in R. So that was it about Babette. You can find it at GitHub and enjoy using her.